Oh my gosh, it's been so long.
Your love is bright as ever. Even in the shadows.
Baby. So much has happened since we have last talked. The last thing I posted was that springtime glowy makeup tutorial, and the same day I had posted a video about a lot of changes that were going to be happening in my YouTube then. That was back in May. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to insert a clip of me talking about the update, and then we'll come back and I'll update you now.
So I planned on making a video about my YouTube update for a while, like while I was in the routine of uploading, but a lot had happened, so that was kind of put on hold. So I thought I'd just put my life update on why I've been gone and my changing YouTube in one video. Not much has been going on. I've just been having to put my focus on some other stuff other than YouTube. So one being, I moved, and I guess you could say it was kind of a random move. I had been planning on moving for a while. I wanted to move by January, but some things didn't work out with my roommate because she was in a specific season in her life and so was I. So I'm glad I didn't move then because that it just wouldn't have worked out. But I don't know, somehow it just came up and we were both looking to move, and so now we're in an apartment. And then also, I just got a job. So that's my life update. So YouTube update, which is what I really want to focus on. When I was in the process of uploading, I didn't like how my YouTube was looking. It wasn't a good and exact replication of who I am. So I was just doing YouTube makeup tutorials, and that's fun. I love makeup. But my life is more than just makeup, and I didn't want to be seen as just a beauty guru because I model, which I don't think I've ever told my YouTube. Maybe I did in my first video, I'm not sure. But I model, so I want to be known as a model, as well as other things, but modeling is really what I want to do with my life. So I model, I'm signed with an agency here in Seattle, Seattle's Model Guild. Love that agency, it's a really good agency, and if you live in the Seattle area and you want to model, I recommend that agency because they have some of the sweetest and the nicest and the most genuine people, and they really, really care about your well-being. But anyways, so I didn't like how my YouTube was showing who I was, and so I love makeup, I also model, but I also have like really cool friends, and so I wanted to be able to like post vlogs of me and my friends, or like random videos with me and my friends, and it makes sense. And I know that like at the top of my cover photo, I think it's, I don't know what they call it, my not template, but you know, the picture that is long ways on top of YouTube, whatever that is, my banner. I think I said I had beauty, lifestyle, and fashion or something like that. And to be quite honest, like, I love fashion, I love shopping for myself, I love helping people out with fashion, but I couldn't see myself making, lookbooks. That's just not, like, what I care about. So that right there kind of put me, it was like, set me to a standard that I didn't even want to do. I didn't want to post those lookbooks, and, or really post anything about fashion. So I changed my description from beauty, lifestyle, and fashion to just beauty and lifestyle because I think that perfectly represents who I am. If I want to vlog myself going on a go-see, it'll make sense, it'll fit in. And if I want to vlog myself with my friends, that fits into lifestyle. So you'll start to see makeup tutorials still, but you'll see videos of me and my friends talking about certain things, talking about life, or just vlogs of me going places with my friends like concerts or wherever we go, I don't know. I want my channel to make sense and to flow cohesively.
So, now that you're all updated on that much, we have more updates. So, that was when I moved into my apartment. I had just started my job. Now I'm moving out of my apartment. And not only am I moving out of my apartment, but I'm gonna be moving across the country. Basically, I have family in New Orleans, it's my dad's side, And I've never in a million years thought of ever living in New Orleans, but you never know what God has planned. I had recently went there in June and had an amazing time, met so many great people, and felt so inspired to do what I love to do, which is just be artistic and be creative and feel free and feel just at peace in my soul. And it was just amazing being around so many awesome creative people who were just non-judgmental, girls and guys. So I came back to work, and just the atmosphere immediately, I just felt, it didn't feel right. I just didn't feel settled. I didn't feel comfortable. I felt like God was telling me that I needed to do something different, but I didn't know what that was. So I kept going to work. I kept doing the whole thing. I was sitting at lunch with a friend, and I was like, I just really want to do something new. I need to do something else. Like, is it a job? I don't know if it's a job, a new job that I want, just something else. So she was helping me look for jobs, and I was just like, okay, I'm gonna think about it. That same day, I got a text from my roommate saying that she's not gonna be renewing the lease. That was September 2nd. And so I was like, oh, okay. So I had asked if she knew where she was living, because I didn't know if we were maybe going to just move in together. And she had already planned to, she already had a place in mind. So, I was like, okay, so I need to find somewhere to live on my own. But I was like, I don't want to find another roommate, a random roommate that I know, that I don't know, because this roommate was my friend. And I don't just do random roommates. That's not what I do. I don't want to live, spend money living in the state where I don't feel like I'm reaching my fullest potential. I don't feel like I'm growing. I just don't feel happy. I don't feel like I'm challenging myself. I don't feel like I'm in a place where God wants me to be. I decided that I'm going to move to New Orleans. So with all that being said, now to the fun part. So when I moved into this apartment, I was watching a lot of moving vlogs. I don't know, I didn't really do a moving vlog for myself because, don't know why, actually. I don't know, I think that maybe it's because it was the first move and it happened, I really don't know. Yeah, so this time we are gonna have a moving vlog, and it's gonna be way more epic because I'm driving across the country with my mama. It is September 14th. It is September 14th, and I have not packed a damn thing. I already had a trip planned to go back out to New Orleans September 27th through October 4th. Since it's gonna be there the 28th, so gotta see my girl. I'm just gonna take that as an opportunity to look for more apartments with my cousin and, just be more acquainted with the area. But that's on the 27th that I fly out. So I have to be packed, and I have to have my stuff at my mom's house here in Washington by the 26th, which means I need to start packing now. I'm not sure if I'm gonna record me packing. I don't really feel like that would be ideal for anybody to have to witness, but I will be, recording the whole traveling part, because I think that would be really fun. I'm so sorry for being gone for 6 months. I hope that you guys are excited to join me on my journey. Yeah, I'm really excited to just show you guys my experience, my journey, my growth in New Orleans, and I hope that you guys are excited to join me. So again, I'm really sorry for my lack of posting. And there's no excuse to that other than the fact that I just didn't feel inspired. I haven't felt inspired for the last 6 months. Anyways, with that being said, I hope that you guys are excited to watch my little travel vlog and this new experience for me. If you want to know when I upload, be sure to subscribe and hit that bell button right next to it so you can know when I upload. Thank you guys so much, and stay tuned.